To start our journey of discussing the Inforiver vision, let's go ahead and look at the reporting features. We'll start by looking at the various navigation options. I'm going to come up to the Home ribbon and select Navigation. Now the default navigation experience, which is Hierarchy, condenses all levels of the hierarchy within a single organized column for both the parent and children levels. Additionally, you can also choose more of a classic table layout, which will take all levels of the hierarchy and separate them out into individual columns. And if you want to further enhance the table layout, you can also choose Stepped Instead, which will then add subtotal rows, as you can see below. And last but not least, if you come up to Navigation and we select Drilldown, you'll be shown one level of the hierarchy at a time, and if you hover over any of these, you'll see an option to say click to drill down. And if we select one of these, it will take you to the next level in that hierarchy and continuing down to those lower levels. And additionally, if you have any visuals on the page, this will also apply a cross filter to those other visuals. Now, besides the navigation experience, you also have quick and easy ways to change the look and feel of the report using templates. If we come up to the Home ribbon and select Templates, so far I've been using the grid layout, which has the option of default and spreadsheet, which are fairly similar to each other. You have more of a clean and simplified look for the financial options as well, for simple and standard. And if you come down to performance, you'll be given an option for 5 different types of IBCS certified templates from T1 through T5 that provides various layouts and designs to analyze your data graphically. When it comes to navigating the table itself, there's a lot of options for both the column and row level hierarchies. Just like in Excel or Power BI, you have the option to have the expand or collapse icons over here that will let you open and close those levels of the hierarchy. Additionally, you have a menu over to the right, which if you open it up, you have options for expand, collapse, or hiding any of these as well if you don't want to show that level as an option for the users to drill down. So I can very easily collapse an entire level if I want to. We also have expand and collapse options up here as well for columns. As an example for Canada, if I open that up, you can see a lower level of the hierarchy now being displayed, with its own dedicated menu as well for any additional options for expanding or collapsing any of those levels, as well as being able to sort the data. Another really great feature is the ability to reorder rows. If we come over to AdventureWorks here and drag this to the top, you can see that it took both the parent and the child nodes and moved them instantly up to the top, and everything below that also migrated with it. In addition to all the row and column options that you saw here, you also have a Manage Columns option. If you come up here, you can see that all the columns are listed in here with corresponding icons to indicate which ones are coming from a data source and which ones have charts applied, plus an option to do a wildcard search for any of the fields. You can also come over to the gear icon, which gives you additional options to choose the aggregation types, the width, or if you wanted to lock the columns as well. Now let's discuss some of the styling options that we have. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to turn on the rail option. And as an example, I'm going to highlight the top row here for all, and I'm going to go ahead and add a border to it. Let's add a thick bottom line to this. On top of being able to make edits to the rows, we can also do it to individual cells, either at the category row level, the cell level, or the header level as well on the columns. Now, another great feature is if I wanted to take the formatting that I had onto this cell, I can come up to the Format Painter. I can also select another entire row down here, which will apply to that whole row. And additionally, if I want to apply it to all other rows in that same level of the hierarchy, I can select Apply Format to Level, which you can see with 2 other rows automatically apply that to the entire table. Additionally, if I wanted to, I could choose to hide any of the rows by selecting the eye icon here, and you'll now be given a down arrow indicator to show that you've hidden rows with the option to also show all rows again if you wanted to unhide them. You also have an option to choose the row height for the entire table itself, or if you wanted to individually make any one of these rows taller, with the option to apply various alignments, both horizontally and vertically. Plus, you also have some intelligent column fit options where you can either choose to fit to header, to fit to the content, or apply in your own manual width, which if you select this will open back up the Manage Column window again. Continuing through the ribbon up here, we also have a lot of different options for number formatting. We come up to the option called Quick Format, we'll notice that right now it is set to measure level, which means that each of the column headers will indicate what scale it is at because the scale is set at the measure level. If I was to select Uniform, you can observe how the column headers have that information removed, and now it is in the table header itself up here in the upper left. Making one more observation, if we were to change this to Auto, we can now observe that each individual cell has its own formatting and scaling applied to it based on the size of the value. And at this point, we could even reduce the numbers down and round it up to the nearest decimal. So one more, there we are. And now that we've configured our numbers a little bit, we also have additional options to come over to the totals here under Analyze, and we can choose to show the row or column totals. Additionally, the positions option down here at the bottom will open up a menu that lets you configure any of the totals to either include them at the top, bottom, left, or right of the table. and also options to enable row subtotal split. If I turn this on, a dedicated total row will now show up for each of the subcategories. And similar to the Excel environment, we also have the option to freeze the total, which as I can scroll down now, you'll see that the all row stays static at the top. Another really useful Excel-like feature is the ability to group columns or rows. As an example, let's go ahead and select all of the variance columns here. I'm going to come up to Group, and I'm going to name this Variance Columns. Select Apply. Plus, just like any other cell, I can choose to apply formatting to this grouped header if I'd like to. I can go ahead and set this to center alignment. Plus, I can use this feature for rows as well. Let's go ahead and select a couple of rows, come back up to Group, give this a title, and I can also choose where to put the new group, either at the top or the bottom. Let's select Apply. Now we can see the new group appearing here with the ability to drill further down into that hierarchy. Last but not least, over in the Actions section, there is an option to export in Excel. We will get to that later during our Analyze section. We also have Redo and Undo options, plus options to reset formats, notes, or all applied changes in the table. Plus an option for Best Fit, which will fit to the data as best as it can for both row height and column width. Coming over to Display, we do have a lot of different options in here when it comes to configuring the report. One really great feature is the ability to easily choose between light and dark modes for both the toolbar and the theme of the table itself. With most of the menu options split up between General, Hierarchy, and Numbers, another really great feature if we come over to Hierarchy is the option for a regular hierarchy to display or not. If we turn this off, notice that companies that do not have a subsidiary are now showing blank rows. So having this as an option built into the tool can be really useful when dealing with regular hierarchies. Let's finish off our reporting features by talking about various aspects of pagination. Come up to the Advanced ribbon. One thing we have an option for is configuring between single page or multi-pages. If you do multiple pages, you have an option to choose where the breaks are, either by various breaks on the categories in the rows or the categories on the columns, with an additional option to choose a section break if desired. And the navigation experience to go between the pages is located in the bottom right. As you can see here, as I click through these, I can go either to the first, the last, or in between any of the pages. Additionally, I can come up here and select header and footer, which will give me many different options to configure the look, the styling, and the data contained within the header itself. Plus, if I come over to header or footer presets and select that, there's a lot of quick and easy to use templates that can include titles or even KPIs. As an example, if I selected KPI and close this out, the header can include cards that are attached to the data and that even include conditional formatting. Plus an option to add a company logo if you desire. Last but not least, if we come back to Advanced, select Reports Plus. This is a great environment for configuring presets that will allow you to create statements or invoices if you plan to do any kind of printing or PDF export of the data itself, with many different templates in here designed to suit your needs.